So dear student, we are coming for the derivation part. There are three equations of motion in class 9 syllabus. Very first equation of motion, it gives the velocity time relation. Equation all of you are supposed to learn, that is the v equal to u plus at, where v is known as the final velocity, u is known as the initial velocity, a is known as acceleration and t is the time. So we have to derive this first equation of motion, that is v equal to u plus at. Firstly, I will discuss the graphical method, then I will discuss the mathematical analysis also. Suppose I say a body is having initial velocity u and it is moving with constant acceleration, and after time t, let velocity become v. Again, I am telling you, let we assume an object is moving with initial velocity u with constant acceleration a, such that after time t velocity becomes v. If I plot this in the velocity time graph, I say this is the time axis, this is the velocity axis. We are taking that initially velocity is u, it means when time is 0, velocity is here, some value is u. And as we say the acceleration is constant, it means all of you intelligent, the graph must be a straight line like this. And it is given to us after time t, let after time t, this is a situation, velocity becomes v. So this is a graphical representation which you are supposed to know. Now, if I measure the acceleration, I think we know very well, acceleration is the slope of velocity time graph. And here if we measure the slope, we make a right angle triangle, we write A, B and C, this is the theta. So acceleration is given by the tan theta, and tan theta is given by AB upon BC. What is AB upon BC? AB can be written as, I said this is D point, then all of you will say AB can be written as DA minus DB upon BC. What is DA? This is D, this is A, DA is nothing but it is a V distance, you just see the Y axis. Minus DB, you see the Y axis, it is U. What is BC? Observe the X axis, it is T. You cross product it, you will get V minus U equal to AT, or you can say V equal to U plus AT. So this is a simple derivation of the first equation of motion. So if somebody asks you to derive the first equation of motion, you will explain the graphically in this way. How we will discuss the mathematically? Now we will discuss the mathematically also. So I have to erase it. Now we will discuss the mathematically. So mathematically, we have to derive v equal to u plus at, that is the first equation of motion. Children, same thing. What we have discussed, an object is traveling with initial velocity u, constant acceleration a, after time t, velocity become v. In the exam, you are supposed to write this language also. Of course, I am explaining, so I am not writing here. Acceleration, all of you know, it is known as a change in velocity upon time. I can say acceleration is final velocity minus initial velocity upon time. Children, if you have taken the situation, as per the situation, what is final velocity? V. What is initial velocity? U. And what is the time taken to change this velocity? That is T. Again, you cross product it, you will get V minus U equal to AT, or V equal to U plus AT. This is the mathematical analysis of the first equation of motion. So we have discussed graphical as well as mathematically about the derivation of the first equation of motion. Now we move for the second equation of motion. second equation of motion. First equation we have derived, all of you just go through it, v equal to u plus at. Second equation that we will derive, that is s equal to ut plus half at square. Again same situation, we have taken initial velocity u, object is with constant acceleration, after time t velocity become v. Firstly we are discussing the graphical method, so let us plot the graph between the velocity and time. Here is the velocity, here is the time. We have taken initial velocity u, it means when time t equal to 0, velocity has some value, that is u, and it is moving with a constant acceleration, it means graph is a straight line. And after time t, it is given to us, velocity is v. This is the velocity is v. Children, all of you know, if the direction is not changing, distance and displacement both are same. Here direction of the motion is not changing. So we say displacement is given by area under the velocity time graph. Means we have to calculate area of this shaded zone. We are just shading it so that you will be able to get which area you are supposed to calculate. So this is the area below the velocity time graph. It will give us the displacement which we have calculated in last video also, and many numericals we have solved, that the area under the velocity time graph gives are the distance and displacement as per the situation we can determine. So if I say I divide into one rectangle and one triangle, or some of you can directly measure the trapezium, it depends on you. Suppose firstly we are taking the trapezium. I say this is O, this is A, this is B, and this is C. Displacement is area of trapezium. This trapezium O, A, B, C. You will say half. Sum of parallel side, this side and this side is parallel. So we will say OA plus OB. And perpendicular distance between the parallel side, this is the perpendicular distance between the parallel side, we will say it is T. So this is S equal to half. What is OA? That is U, observe the graph. What is B, OB? It should be BC. OA, this is BC. So half u plus v into t, and from first equation v equal to u plus at, so you calculate it, s equal to half into 2u plus at into t. We don't have space, so we are moving towards this side. S equal to half into 2u into t plus half at into t. When we calculate, we will get s equal to ut plus half at square. This is the derivation of second equation of motion. So then we have taken the area of trapezium. Some of you can calculate by taking the area of the triangle plus area of the rectangle also. When you calculate it, you will get the same result. Area of the rectangle, this is u, this is t, it means area of the rectangle is ut. What is the area of the triangle? Half base into height. What is base? That is given ut. What is height? This is the height, and you will say this distance is v, this distance is u, so this is v minus u. Again you put the values, you will get the answer, because v equal to u plus at, u will be cancelled, you will get the half at square here, you get the ut here, and you can easily calculate the answer. So this is the graphical analysis of second equation of motion. Now same second equation we will discuss mathematically also. As we have taken the situation, object has initial velocity u, final velocity is v, this is the final velocity after some time t, and we have taken the acceleration is small a. If we calculate the distance traveled or displacement, direction is not changing, we will say it is the average velocity into time. What is average velocity? It is u, it is v, acceleration is constant. We will say average velocity is u plus v by 2. And what is time taken? Time is t. And from first equation, we say v equal to u plus at. Put the values here. We get s equal to u plus at upon 2 into t. We solve it. S equal to u plus u is 2u plus at by 2 into t. S equal to, open the bracket, 2u upon 2 into t plus at upon t into t. We solve it. We get s equal to ut plus half at square. So we have discussed both the method, graphical method as well as mathematical method. So up to this reason we have discussed two equations. First is the v equal to u plus at, second is the s equal to ut plus half at square. Now we will move for the third equation of motion. So even for the third equation, again firstly I will discuss the graphical analysis, then mathematical. It takes same situation. Object is traveling initial velocity u with constant acceleration. After time t, velocity becomes v. We plot the graph. Now I think all of you are expert. If you have to plot the graph for this situation between velocity and time, you can easily plot the graph like this. And you can label it. This is u, time is 0. This is time t, velocity is v. This also you can label it easily, no problem. And all of you know, distance is the area under the graph. So I am directly writing here. Distance is given by, if I mark the trapezium O, A, B, C, I will say distance is area of O, A, B, C trapezium. So what is this? S equal to half. This is O, A, parallel side. This is B, C, parallel side, because we know area of the trapezium half. Sum of parallel side into perpendicular distance, that is the OC into OC. So we get S equal to half. OA is nothing but U, BC is nothing but V, OC is nothing but T, that we are getting it. So children, use the first equation of motion here, V equal to U plus AT. From this equation I can write AT equal to V minus U and T equal to V minus U upon A. We put this at the value of the T here. What we get, I am writing here because no space there. Displacement S equal to half, u plus v can be written as v plus u, t can be written as v minus u upon a. And children, I think all of you are aware, a plus b into a minus b is a square minus b square. So next step we can write S equal to v square minus u square upon 2a. When I cross product and I adjust, I get the third equation, that is v square equal to u square plus 2as. So this is the third equation we have derived with the help of the graphical analysis. So same equation we will discuss with mathematically also. And children, one more thing, for the graphical I have taken the trapezium. It is not necessary. As I told in the last slide, we can say we are taking the rectangle, this one, and we can take the triangle, right angle triangle, this one, and same result we will get. You can verify, no problem with it. So now I am going for the mathematical. So mathematical, same thing we are telling, that object is traveling with initial velocity u, constant acceleration a, after time t, velocity becomes v. Now what is the displacement? Displacement is known as, we say it is the, so displacement is known as average velocity into time. Average velocity, final velocity is v, initial velocity u divided by time, because acceleration is constant, so we say average velocity into time t. From first equation of motion, v equal to u plus at, we calculate at equal to written as v minus u, and t can be written as v minus u upon a. Put this value of the t here, we get s equal to v plus u divided by 2, v minus u divided by a. Children, I think all of you know a plus b, a minus b is a square minus b square. So next step we are writing s equal to v square minus u square upon 2a, and by doing the cross product we calculate v square minus u square equal to 2as. So this is the third equation of motion. We can write in this format also, it doesn't matter. V square equal to u square plus 2as. So children, we have derived all the three equations. Again I am telling you, what is the first equation? First equation is nothing but v equal to u plus at. What is second equation? S equal to ut plus half at square. What is third equation? V square equal to u square plus 2as. Sometimes you want distance traveled in the nth second. That formula only I am giving to you. Of course, in the advanced lecture, I will discuss the derivation also. Distance traveled in nth second is given by u plus a by 2, 2n minus 1. All of you just learned this formula. Of course, I will discuss the derivation of this part also in the advanced lectures of class 9. But until then, you just learn this formula, remember this formula. Displacement in nth second is given by u plus a by 2, 2n minus 1. And distance in t second is given by ut plus half a t square. So there is difference in distance travel in t second, distance travel in tth second. Both the formula you are supposed to know. So I have given you four formulas here, four equations here. On the best of these four equations, we will solve the numericals. Thank you.